easier to work with, right? Safety. You don't want it slipping around on your cutting board. Pat dry. Just my kids when they come out of the shower. Except they have like, one has a robot towel, and one has a fox towel. I had my 6-year-old do this once. Break down a whole chicken. Still doesn't talk to me.
He's talking.
Yes, kid. He still doesn't talk to me. Okay, then, many of you have either never, how many of you never held a whole chicken before? I found that's pretty common. So the next step we're going to do is orient yourself. What does the word orient mean?
A sign.
It means east. Orient means east, but it's a term we use to kind of get familiar with where you are. Where is east? But orient means east. Okay. So then you're gonna, then the way you're gonna do that is you can kind of stand it up. And this will laugh a little bit, but it'll help you. Makes it real now, right? Things just got real. And this is and so that now this has a little different meaning for you, doesn't it? It's not just something that was in plastic wrap. This was a living animal, maybe a month ago. Now it's really cold and featherless. Okay. And headless. Okay, so you're gonna place it on its back. Right? And you know the head would be here, it's like it's suntanning. Okay? This is what I do in the summer. First thing you're first cut, step number one, is safety cuts. You see this taut little skin right here? You're going to do a little cut here and a little cut here, and hyperextend the legs. Like that. And that's going to provide a nice perch and base for you to work on. Is this how you all did it? Okay, so now we're back here. Since we're back here, we're going to get rid of the fat in the back. So trim excess fat while you're back here. And then it'll go over here. This will be our parts trim. You can render that down and produce schmaltz, rendered chicken fat. Really good. Have you had french fries and chicken fat? Or dumplings? This is good. So now that we're back here, so this right here, we call it a pope's nose. I forgot what the real name is, but what is this? What grows out of here? The tail. What grows out of here? The tail. Feathers. What's the purpose of the tail feathers? A little balance, and what else? To shake. Why? Why do hens shake their tail feathers? Possibly. It's related to that. It's about mating. Yes. So the hens shake their tail feathers to attract the mate. So what that tells us is inside here, there is a scent gland that secretes oil that moves up the feather. She shakes her tail feathers. It gets in the air, and the roosters are like, "What's that?" And then they're attracted to it. That's helpful for us as cooks because we don't want that in our stock. It adds a much bitterness to your stock. So remove that. Okay. So again, we're always going to try and get you back to the why. You know, if the chef comes by, make sure you take that off. Okay, chef. But now you know why we take that off, and you'll probably remember that. Okay. So then we're done on this back end. Now we're going to turn it 180 degrees. And we're going to work our way in from the outside. This section is the wing tips. Then we have the wings. Then we have the drumettes. Wing tips, wings, drumettes. The way we're going to remove these is, if these are all ball and socket joints. So ball, socket, they fit together. The joint moves like that. Right? There's collagen in between that helps protect bone on bone. So you find out how the joint moves. who's like this. This is where the exposed part is. You're going to cut to expose the joint. You're going to hyperextend. Hyperextend. There's the ball. There's the socket.